Hey there, Vanessa here. I want to ask you, what do you think about multi-level marketing and or network marketing? Do you think it's a pyramid scheme? Do you think that it's a scam? Well, I want to take you on a little journey on comparing a corporate America company to a network marketing company. We're going to compare the structure and then see the similarities. So then you tell me, is it a scam or is it just smart business?
Hey, Mama, this is Vanessa Ann Miller. My sidekick, Oliver, and I are excited to share some insight of being a mom, wife, entrepreneur, and definitely one gold digger. I'm going to teach you my time hacks and business tips on how to be the most efficient, modern mompreneur, and we're going to have fun along the way. So go ahead and get your pen, paper, and don't forget your coffee.
Think of network marketing and multi-level marketing businesses. Do you think that they're a pyramid scheme? Do you think that it's a scam? Depending on whether you're actually working the business or you're on the outside looking in, you could have your own opinion about it. Well, I want to take you on a little comparison of a network marketing structure compared to a corporate America company structure. And then I want to get your opinion after that. So let's look at this.
When you compare the structure of an MLM to another company, they both have some kind of management system. Usually, these managers are paid with a bonus or some other incentive to make sure that the people that they're supervising perform well. They also have a way to weed out, so if you will, people that are not performing well. In an MLM, usually the people that are not selling tend to drop off the team. And with a regular company, there is some kind of maybe performance, audit every year. And if they're not meeting their requirements, then they're let go. They both provide a way for people to make money to provide for their families. So in essence, they are very, very similar in their structure. MLMs also save money by having a performance-based compensation structure.
Now that we did that comparison, I think that it is smart business. It is smart business to pay someone by performance instead of having the overhead cost of employee payroll, employee benefits, and a storefront if they were to have a brick and mortar.
So, why do network marketing businesses get such a bad rep?
Well, I think it is a lot to do with the distributors that are joining. They are not trained entrepreneurs. They are getting trained by their upline, and those upline aren't necessarily entrepreneurs either. And so when there's fallout and there's high turnover, people tend to blame the upline or the company or network marketing company itself. Just like when someone gets fired. They blame their boss. Oh, they fired me because of whatever. And it gets a bad reputation. And so, how can we change that bad reputation of multi-level marketing, network marketing, just cut through the stigma? I believe that every distributor should go through some kind of training to set a foundation for their business. All of the network marketing training out there is all about recruiting, how to post on social media. Yeah, those things are great, but when you don't have that foundation, like a business blueprint, then you're jumping ahead. You're putting the cart before the horse. Or I like to say is that you are putting a chandelier in your home before you even built the house. Tell me if this sounds like the way you started your network marketing business. You were told to make a list of 100 prospects, and you were told just to call those people, and most likely they were friends and family. You're asked to get them on a phone call with your upline so you could talk about your business products and your business opportunity. And by the time you were maybe a third of the way through there, you either got some hits or you probably got some strikeouts, and it got you really frustrated and defeated. Well, I think that when you're starting a network marketing business, you should lay the foundation and have a plan to lead with your passion. Not everyone needs your product, and not everyone wants your business opportunity. So, what does that look like? That looks like you doing some market research on your ideal client. What exactly do they want? Are they able to afford your products? Were they getting some information about solutions that your product can solve? It is my mission to help change the stigma of multi-level marketing and help reduce the burnout that distributors face whenever no one wants to talk to them anymore. They're getting ghosted and they're just feeling defeated. I want to take them from confused to confident in their business. I don't want them to get ghosted anymore. And as you, if you're a prospect, I don't want you to feel like you're getting sold all the time. So I created a really cool resource. It is a quiz to help uncover which business blueprint will help you lead with your passion based on your personality and your talents. This is gonna help network marketing mamas go from feeling salesy, sleazy, and spammy to feeling confident in their sales and prospecting approach. Go to vanessaannmiller.com/quiz to take it now. It's a really fun one because it's celebrity based. Well, don't forget to leave me your takeaways and share this with someone that you think that would benefit from the quiz tremendously. See you next week.